The microbes in the ocean are the very small organisms that we can't see with the naked eye. We start with the smallest there, the viruses, very, very tiny. And if we take a teaspoon of water as a measure, then we're looking at many millions of viruses in a teaspoon of water from the ocean. And if we go the next step up, we start to think about the bacteria. Again, very small, microscopic, around about 2 to 5 million in a teaspoon of water. If we go to the next size up, we're starting to look at the algae or the small single-cell plants that we call phytoplankton. And in a teaspoon of water, we're looking at several thousand to maybe 30, 40, 50,000. And then if we go the next step up of the microbes, we get into the very small microscopic animals that eat the bacteria and the small phytoplankton. And there we're looking at, in a teaspoon of water, 1 to 2 in a teaspoon of water. The microbial loop in the ocean is the all the microbial organisms and their relationships to each other in terms of their interactions in the food web. The microbial loop forms the very bottom of the food web with all the microscopic organisms. So we have the bacteria taking up organic material from the water and growing. We have the algae using sunlight to photosynthesize and grow, and then we have the microzooplankton that then eat the bacteria and the algae. And those microzooplankton then release in their feces nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus that are really important for the growth of the bacteria and the algae, and they recycle that back into the system. We've got to remember also that once we get out of that microbial loop, then those small microzooplankton are eaten by larger zooplankton, and that then goes up through the food web to the larger organisms, to fish and marine mammals in the Southern Ocean. Also, you get the cycling of carbon in the water. So you get release of organic carbon by the algae and also the microzooplankton, and that's taken up by the bacteria. So you get quite a quick cycling of both nutrients and carbon within the microbial loop. And that's really important in terms of how fast things are moving and cycling within the ocean. And also, when you have a dominance of the microbial loop in the ocean, you tend to get a lot of recycling in the upper waters, and then you don't get as much carbon, the big algae and the larger zooplankton growing with lots of carbon sinking out into the deep ocean, what we call carbon sequestration, where you take carbon out of the atmosphere into the water, it's used by the algae and then taken into the deep ocean.